Today we're going to take a look at and talk about ArtLand Disney pins. I showed one really cool Stitch and Angel ArtLand pin in a recent video, but if you missed that, ArtLand pins are Disney licensed pins. They're produced by ArtLand, which is a European distributor for Acme. And Acme produces a whole bunch of Disney licensed artwork. Acme used to have the license to produce pins, and over the past years, they produced quite a number of really awesome high quality pins, but now that license has been transferred over to ArtLand. So the ArtLand pins are essentially the same type of pins that Acme was producing. These pins are probably like the highest quality Disney licensed pins out there, and they're really like the most artistic ones that you'll find. Since these pins are based on artwork designs from Acme, they're generally some of the kind of most unique visual pins you'll come across. I really like pins because they're a really nice collectible, but they are also kind of like little mini art pieces. But these pins really do feel like the closest thing to actual little pieces of metal artwork. So I was very kindly sent along a number of these ArtLand pins to be able to share and show today. All of these ArtLand pins are very low edition sizes, like talking in between LE 300 to 100. So in terms of their rarity and edition size, they rival that of WDI or Disney Studio Store Hollywood pins. They typically do, though, have a slightly higher retail price than normal, and that's because these pins are kind of considered to be a bit more fine art, and also, of course, with their low edition size. There's a few various different ways that you can acquire ArtLand pins. There are some distributors across the world that will have different ones available. I'm also going to link to the Pulse Gallery, which is an online site where you can buy a number of these pins directly. But I'm excited to be able to show and check out some of these pins. Like I said, in terms of quality, these are probably the highest quality Disney licensed pins you'll find. Like, if we're talking about the quality of like box lunch lounge fly pins is here, the ArtLand pins are way, way up here. All these pins come in the cellophane packaging, so I'm gonna take that off and share these really cool pins. So this first pin here is this truly incredible pin featuring Maleficent. This probably definitely has to be like the heaviest, like sturdiest, thickest Disney pin I've ever held. This is a limited edition of 250, and it's part of a 4-pin villain series. I have one other pin from this series to share, and this is just stunning. As you can see, the background is this beautiful transparent enamel, and then you can kind of see these fiery flame details. She definitely has that kind of menacing, Maleficent look about her. And here you can see just how insanely thick this pin is. Like, it kind of is a little bit nuts. So these pins do actually come with the rubber Mickey pin backs on them, and the backer cards also serve as a certificate of authenticity. So I'll take the pin backs off to fully see this. So all the pins come with the certificate of authenticity backer cards, which tells you that it is a limited edition collectible pin. It'll typically have handwritten the edition size on the back. Sometimes it'll specifically say which edition number it is. And then at the bottom, it says that it is produced by ArtLand under a license from Disney. So this is the Maleficent pin off of the backer card. And like I said, truly, this is like so heavy and hefty to hold. Like, it's just incredible for a pin. And then the back stamp of these has a standard gold bars like all of the Acme pins used to have. Say it states that it's an officially licensed pin from ArtLand. On the back of this pin, however, it doesn't say the actual edition size, so that information is only on the backer card. I do have one other pin from this villain set to share, and this features the Old Hag. The two other villain pins that they have feature the Queen of Hearts and Cruella de Vil. So this one is pretty much in the exact same style as Maleficent. It has this beautiful green transparent filled background. She's holding the apple there. This again is a super large size pin. Again, the same super thick, heavy duty size. But as you can see on our backer card here, this one is actually marked as a PP pin. So this is a pre-production pin. And you can get PP and AP pins from ArtLand by request. So again, here it is just off of the backer card. Truly just another insanely stunning pin. You'll need to make sure you have a pretty hefty duty cork board to be able to hold this up. But then on the back of this, you can see that it does have the PP stamp, so you know that this one is a pre-production. I then have a few pins from their cutout series to share. These are all LE200. So these cutout pins are, I guess I'd call them like a normal sized pin, but they're still super pretty with their detail. This first one features Pascal and he's holding Rapunzel's tiara. I'm not a Tangled collector, but I love the design of this so much. This would be like a must have if you're really big into Tangled. So with the backer card here, it's the same type of certificate of authenticity, and when you remove the pin back, you can see written edition size of 200. So again, this one is kind of more of, you know, the normal scale of a Disney pin. This is kind of closer to your average thickness, but it's just super, super cute. It has kind of a smaller size version of the gold bar print, and if you can see, it does have a stamp on there where it says 121 out of 200, and then otherwise it also does have the standard ArtLand information there. Also from the LE200 cutout series is this pin featuring the March Hare from Alice in Wonderland. I think it's nice to feature a character like this who doesn't typically get as much representation, and I think it's also really nice to have like a full-bodied character as a pin. So this one isn't per se a small pin, but it is on the smaller size compared to the rest of these ArtLand pins, but a really neat LE200. And then the last pin from the cutout series I have to share is this super cute Marie pin. The other three pins in this set feature Cheshire Cat, Snow White, and Grumpy. But on this one, we have Marie from the Aristocats, and she's raising her nose up. She's looking a little bit snooty. But I have been getting more into Disney cat themed pins because, you know, I do want my feline children to also have a pin collection that celebrates themselves. So this cute Marie kind of reminds me of my Micah because they are both pretty sassy ladies. The rest of the pins that I have to share are all back to being much larger in size. And this one is called Girls' Day Out. It is an LE100 and it features Minnie Mouse and Daisy going shopping. That probably definitely is my favorite type of Girls' Day Out. If you can see here, they actually make the store window look like a real window because they have an epoxy resin over it. But there's so much pretty screen printing detailing on this. I love all the polka dots on Minnie's outfit. The pin also has a lot of dimensionality to it. So the molds itself aren't necessarily thick, but they kind of add up to being a really awesome pin. Just a quick look at the certificate of authenticity showing that this is a limited edition of 100. And then there's the pin here off of the backer card. So on the back here, you can see it just has the two pin posts on here, and this part kind of functions as like a super big pin on pin, but this makes me wish I could now go on a shopping girl's day out. Then we have Pianist Mickey, which is another limited edition of 100, and I think that this has to be my personal favorite design out of all of them. I think the artwork of this pin is just absolutely gorgeous. It features Mickey Mouse at this grand piano. He has kind of sheet music all over the place. It even has this M&M in the background there. And I think that it's also really cool that this pin is all in black and white. And like the previous pin, this also does have a lot of layers, this kind of extra pin on pin to give it some really cool dimension. Then you can see off the backer card, just another really large size, beautiful pin. I did play the piano growing up. I took lessons for quite a number of years, but I think my skills have gotten a little bit rusty at this point. But this pin is also cool because it's all done in this kind of dark gray metal finish. There is then this other pin featuring Minnie and Mickey called Punting in the Country, and it is an LE of 200. This one, like the others, just has so many interesting design elements. So you have Minnie and Mickey there in a pin-on-pin there. And then this bush, it's not like a 3D. It kind of like feels plasticky, but it's all raised and beveled to look like an actual bush there. They give the water this translucent effect to make it actually look like water. You have all that screen printing detail for the stonework. So this again is kind of like where these pins really feel like little works of art. But just so super pretty off of the backer card. This looks like something from a painting that's direct from an art museum. I then have one final ArtLand pin to share. This pin actually has not yet been released. This is gonna be released in the US in mid-April, and I think it's an event exclusive release in Europe early April. But this is the matching Angel and Stitch pin to go with the other one that I showed in a previous video. And this pin is called Kei Aloha, which means beloved. I think the design of this is so, so sweet. You have Angel embracing Stitch. And then this pin, like the first two villain pins and like the previous Stitch pin I showed, is also super, super thick. So just really awesome high quality on this one. This pin, like the other Angel and Stitch pin, is also a limited edition of 150. And, you know, even though this one doesn't have any kind of like pin on pin or those extra elements, the design of this, I really just think is so, so adorable. I just really quickly wanted to share some of the Acme pins I had in my collection. So again, the Acme pins were basically the predecessor to the ArtLand pins. It just kind of switched over the license, but they otherwise have super similar styles. And if you've come across the Acme pins, you can basically expect similar types from the ArtLand pins. This first pin here that I have features Marie and Toulouse, but I loved this pin because our two kitty cats love to fight and then they like try to act all innocent. So this is again another pin for my cats. But this was from a set that I think had different variants where the metal was different colors. And this one is a super pretty rose gold variant. Now with the Acme pins, some of them did have different numbers stamped on them because they could actually be used in kind of gameplay. I think the game was called Panopolis. So that there is not the edition size. You can kind of see it stamped here that this is a limited edition of 500. I have another LE500 pin here. This one I think was from an Acme cutout series, and it features Belle in her blue dress reading a book. I loved the amount of screen printing detail they had on this, and I don't really collect much Beauty and the Beast, but I do really like when there is Belle in her blue dress. So again, with that 51 on the back stamp, I don't know that means if it's 51 out of 500 or that 51 stamp had to do with a gameplay value. And then the last Acme pin that I have also features Belle, and it was part of their Golden Magic series. I remember I got this pin when PinPics was doing at-cost opportunities for these pins. And this pin is another just super stunning one. It has a lot of that transparent enamel, kind of like how the Maleficent and Old Hag pins did. It has all this pretty screen printing detail on it, and they had a whole set of these really neat stylized princesses. The larger Acme pins also came on their backer cards that served as certificate of authenticities. And this Belle is just such another large sized pretty pin. So on the back here, this does say it's limited edition of 300. So I think that it is number 45 out of 300, and that 192 had to do with the gameplay value. So hopefully this was kind of interesting to take a look at these ArtLand pins and see a different type of Disney pin that's out there and available. I know a lot of people lament that like, oh, they don't live anywhere near Hollywood and can't get, you know, studio store pins themselves, or they're not a cast member and can't get WDI pins. But these pins are great if you're looking for really high quality, low limited edition size pins and ones that are generally more easily accessible to the average person. So thank you again to the folks at ArtLand for sending along these pins so we can check them out. And I'm really looking forward to see what upcoming designs they have available. But thanks for watching!